Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video we are going to see voltage variation across RLC circuit. So this is basically a series RLC circuit and it has got an special property. So that is, voltage across the inductor leads by 90 degree as compared to the resistor, and voltage across capacitor lags by 90 degree as compared to the resistor here, and the voltage across the resistors will be equal to the voltage across the source. So that property we will try to discuss in this video, and we will also draw the graph. So I have already drawn the graph because it will take lot of time for me to draw while shooting the video. So that's why instead I thought I will be delivering small information when I will be writing simultaneously. So instead I thought, why not to write first and then I will explain, so that I can give a better information in a small time period, so that in two ways the information will be higher. Okay, now coming to this topic, so I will just write for inductor, that is L, voltage leads, right? So for capacitor, voltage lags here. Okay, now why this happens, let us try to find out. Okay, so this is inductor, right? So when you pass a current through this one, then it will induce the magnetic field across this one, so there will be an induction of magnetic field. So this is the magnetic field, right? So what this will do, according to Lenz's law, it will limit the amount of current flowing through the inductor. So it will try to decrease the amount of current, because electric and magnetic fields are opposite to each other. Current will induce the electric field, and due to the property of this inductor, it will create a magnetic field. Okay, so that when the current is decreased, then voltage will be leading, because it will not oppose the voltage, it will oppose the current here, so that the voltage will be leading and current will be less in case of inductor. Okay, so that's why the voltage leads in case of inductor, because the created magnetic field will oppose the current. So note that the created magnetic field is also basically how the magnetic field is created. It is created due to the electric field, the current which is passing through the coil, but it is something like you are opposing to someone who is the creator of you. Okay, so it is just like we are opposing to our father who is the creator. Okay, so that example best fits here. So the creator of this magnetic field is this current, and when the magnetic field is formed, it is indeed opposing the current itself, getting higher. Okay, so that's basically explained by the scientist Lenz. So that is called as Lenz law. Okay, so now you have got the idea why the voltage leads in case of inductor. Okay, now coming to the capacitor. Okay, so I will draw a capacitor. So this is a parallel plate capacitor which is having two plates here, and when current comes to this capacitor, so what it will do, the charges will be accumulated. Let us say plus will be accumulated in this side and minus will be accumulated at this side. Okay, so what it will do, it so voltage will be formed when the charges from this plate will go to this plate. Okay, so at that time some voltage, that let us say V, will be formed on these plates. Okay, so the charges start accumulating on this plate, and when they are fully accumulated at this plate, then only they can go to this plate. Okay, so let us say first and second plates. Then to go to second place, the first, there is the charges density should increase at the first place. So some time will be taken by the capacitor to go transfer the charges from this plate to this plate. But the current will be increasing continuously. So they will not oppose the current here. They will oppose the voltage increase across these two plates here. So that's why voltage will lag. So if current is voltage is leading in case of inductor, then current will be lagging here. So current will be having a direction lower. So in case of voltage lag, then current is having a upper direction. Okay, so voltage lags means current will lead. Voltage leads means current will lag here. So in case of capacitor, due to this reason, the capacitor current will be leading and voltage will be lagging here. So voltage lags in case of capacitor. Okay, so in case of resistors, both will be increasing or decreasing linearly, that is simultaneously. As the source voltage increase, the resistor value will also increase without any these extra efforts. Okay, so these are the two properties due to which the capacitor and inductor voltage lags and leads. Okay, so I hope you understood why these are lagging and leading in case of this these two components, capacitor and inductor. Now coming to graph. Okay, so I have taken a sine wave here. So this is basically a sine wave. Okay, so this is the input wave. So let us say source wave. So this is the source which I have taken, that is cosine wave here. It is starting from 1. Okay, so it is coming like this. Now the one which is in green color, that is inductor voltage. So this is the inductor voltage. So what is inductor? Inductor voltage leads. Okay, so inductor voltage will be leading the resistor voltage. Okay, so that's why I have written like this here. So the inductor voltage will be, so this is the resistor voltage starting from this point, then I will be drawing like this. So this is the actual sine wave, this is leading here. So this is the actual input source, so this is leading, so this is higher than the, or this is in time before that of the input resistance, input source source voltage. So this is the source voltage and this is the voltage across the inductor. So clearly we can see the voltage across the inductor is in higher in time as compared to the voltage wave. So that's why here it can be said that the inductor voltage is leading here. Okay, so this will continue for every cycle. Now for capacitor it should lag. So I will start from zero and I will draw like this. So it is the capacitor voltage is lagging here. Again, this will start from here and it will come up to here. So capacitor, so here it can you can see clearly here. Okay, so this is the main wave or the one which is applied. Then here inductor voltage leads by 90 degree and capacitor voltage lags by 90 degree. Okay, that I have written here also. Inductor voltage leads and capacitor voltage lags. So first draw one source voltage wave, then one voltage wave, that is inductor will be leading the source voltage wave and capacitor will be lagging the source voltage wave. So like this, with the help of these three components and basic understanding, we can visualize the voltage lead and lag concept in case of series RLC circuit. So I hope you found this video a little bit informative. So if you found this informative, please guys hit the like button, and if you are not subscribed to the channel, please guys do subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.